Hello everyone, this is Abhijit and today we are going to see how we can use a copilot to generate the cloud formation for us. So let's consider a simple scenario where we have a Lambda, a execution role for the Lambda which has access to S3 and DynamoDB and an event source mapping setup from S3 to Lambda. So whenever there will be a put object on S3, then our Lambda will get triggered. So let's get started and see how we can use copilot to generate this cloud formation. The first step in our journey is to take the parameters input from the input to the cloud formation. So let's add a query to our copilot. So create the CFN input parameter for Lambda DynamoDB and S3 name. So let's see what copilot generates for us. Okay, so you can see that it is generating a result. So it has taken Lambda name, DynamoDB and bucket name as a parameters. So I think this solutions looks good to me, so I will accept this solution. Okay, so now the next step is to generate the resources. So let's create a Lambda. Okay, then we will have the IAM execution role for the Lambda. Okay, and this with access to S3 and DynamoDB. Okay, so let's see what copilot generates for us. Okay, so you can see now it has created a Lambda function, okay, and execution role which has a put object and then get object on an S3 bucket name that we have passed as a parameter and a DynamoDB. So this solution looks good to me, so I will accept this solution. Okay, so now the next step is to generate an event source mapping from an S3 to Lambda. So create the event source mapping from S3 to Lambda on port object. Okay, so let's see what it generates. Okay, so you can see that it has generated an event source mapping where batch size is 10 and your event source mapping is going to trigger a Lambda whenever there is a put object on the Lambda. So let's accept this solution. Okay, maybe this has become double, so I will delete this. Okay, so now let's see what other fields we can add, right? So let's say we need to add a handler for it, right? Add a handler. So you can see it is suggesting me that you want an handler for index.handler. So let's accept this. So we will hit the tab button to accept this. So now let's add a timeout. Okay, so you can see it is suggesting me to add a timeout. Now it is also giving me recommendations. So it is saying you want to add a runtime. So let's add a runtime also. Okay, so runtime, so it is saying for Node.js, maybe I will not take Node.js, I will give it simple Python 3. So it is suggesting me to 8, but let's go to Python 3.10. Okay, so like you can add other fields also, like suppose if you want to go with adding the architecture. So if you want to add a layer to it, so it will give us the code to add a Lambda layer to it. So like you can see it is suggesting us things. So I think that was it from the demo of the cloud formation, and thank you.